I'll tell you a brief story because it seems irrelevant. Seems a relevant place to do this. This is the story. My mum took me to a party when I was 8 years old. And it's in the 60s. Everyone's grooving around. Yes? And my mother's there, and she's got me by the hand. Come on, go into the room with all the other children and dance. The eyes are the windows to the soul. No, groovy, groovy. Go in. Yes, you remember. So she said, go into the room and dance with all the other kids. And I said, I don't want to go and dance around. Well, I don't want to go and dance with all the other kids. I want to stay with you, Mum. And then my mother says, go on, let yourself go. Let yourself go, man. Do you know that phrase, let yourself go? You've heard of that? Yes. Just let yourself go. Ding! Someone's letting themselves go right over there. Let yourself go. Let yourself go. And I didn't have a clue. I'd never heard that phrase before. And that intrigued me. Let myself go? Wow, suddenly for one moment, I had a real cognitive awareness, sort of existential awareness. And hey, well, what is the self I've got to let go? What is that thing? And then this set me off on some big psychological movement through my life. And then when I was 40, working for the first time in Japan, I was working at the New National Theatre, working with some young people, not unlike you, who had trained as actors, who were actors, but they figured they needed something else. So I was along and I was working with them, and we were going to do a Shakespeare. And we started on the Shakespeare. And at the end of rehearsals, this beautiful young woman came up and she said, Jeremy-san, you should meet my sensei. And as you know, sensei is the top banana in the Buddhist world. The big teacher, he's the big guy, you know, the sensei. And I said, yeah, sure, come on. I always like to say yes a lot when I'm abroad and just do stuff. I love to do that. I have big adventures. Crazy adventures. And so she said, you must meet my sensei. So I said, sure. And on the Saturday, I met with her. We had the CDT ceremony a few days before. And there was my producer, there was my translator, and there was this very beautiful actress. And they said, come on, we got on the train. We got on the bullet train. Shwang! Which took us from Tokyo to Kyoto. Bong, dong, bong, bong, dong, bing, dang, dong. It was wonderful. All these kimono women walking around. Just very polite, very discreet. The cultural center of Japan. It's one of the most beautiful places I've been to. And we get to Kyoto, and then we start walking. And we walk up a little hill, which becomes quite a big hill. And we walk up quite a big hill, and it becomes a mountain. And after a little while, we're on the top of the world, it seemed to me. And I'm standing on the top of the world with my beautiful actress and my producer and the translator. And we say nothing. It is a beautiful place. And we've arrived at a Zen rock garden with the five standing stones and the red sand like this. And down there we can see Kyoto, right down there. And there's some trees, the pine trees, and some little birds, and there's a little stream running. And we sit. And then, out comes this guy, smaller than me, but only in height. And he walked out in his red robes. This is the sensei, the top banana. Didn't have a man at his tongue. And he walked out quite slowly with his robes. And he bowed. Ohayo gozaimasu. Hello. And then we sat down. And we discoursed. And we talked about nature. And we talked about creativity. And we talked about the arts. And we talked about culture. Turns out we didn't really need the translator because his English was slight American accent. His English was perfect, though. Very learned, very cultured man. And then there was a break in the conversation. Do you want some tea? No, I don't actually. I want to have the tea, thanks. Some water, very pure water from the well. And then there was a pause in the conversation, and the actress turned to me, and I said, sensei, Hey, I wonder if you can tell me. My mother took me to a party when I was 8. Oh, wow. She said, go into the room. Let yourself go, is what she said. Let yourself go! And I wonder, dear sensei, can you tell me what she meant by the self I had to let go? He clapped his hands, and all the birds flew up from the pine trees. And he said, this is the Western perception of self. Can you do this for me right now? He says, this is the Western perception of self, which is two eyes looking out of a bag of skin. And it's just little me in here, and you're nothing to do with me, and I'm nothing to do with you. This is the Western perception of self. I'm just some little shitty farty thing sitting in a bag of skin looking out at you, and you're looking back at me. And I'm not connected to you, and you're not connected to me. And you know what? He said also, this idea of self is, well, sod you, I'm alive. I'm just a big thing. Fuck you, I'm the bee's knees. Yes, I'm the greatest thing since sliced bread. And he said, but there's also the flip side of this Western perception of self is this. Oh, it's just a little me. And I'm just a useless piece of something, and it's scared and vulnerable, as well as being truculent and a bit aggressive. But he said, this is the Western perception of self. Do you recognize this Western perception of self? Do you know this? He said, this is the big illusion. Man, this is the big illusion, and this is the illusion of ego. Which actually, really, doesn't exist. No, time doesn't exist. We don't have the time to go into that again, but time doesn't exist. No more than ego. It's a construct. And when we go for our auditions, oh yes, it's just little me. Or when we meet our directors, and when we, all this little way, yes, oh hi, I'm just in here. But he said, this is an illusion. Don't believe that. This is the Western perception of self. And then he asked me a question, which I'll never forget. He looked me straight in the eye and he said, tell me, where do you begin and I end?
For what?
Where do you begin and I end? Where do you begin and I end? He said, we're all part of it all. Don't you just see that? Don't you feel that? What do you mean? He said, well, where does your bottom end and the floor begin? See these trees out here? These trees, CO2 plus H2O, in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll, gives you C6H12O2, or something. Wait, oxygen's given out with photosynthesis, right? But so the plants, he says, are our external lungs, and we breathe that in. We're connected to them. And yet they're chopping down the rainforest all over the place. It's nuts. See the river? See the little stream? See that stream? We're 80% water, as we talked about in the previous meeting. We're all 80% water, as the planet, 80% water. We don't recognize that that's all interconnected. Sure. And then he said, see the little bee, little bee around, flying about. Without bees, we're all dead. And we know this about the ecosystem. And yet there's GM all over the place, and they're poisoning, Monsanto, buying up rice. Copyright on rice. Yes, Monsanto owns rice. Whoa. That's very interesting, isn't it? Watch out. And so, without these, we're all dead. He said, we're all interconnected. It's all about interbeing. And if we forget that for one moment and go back to this again, then of course we're working anti-nature. And I thought, man, this is really interesting for my actors, who often are going around like this, So I said, arigato gozaimasu, thank you very much. He said, oh, it's good, no problem. And we walked down the mountain, and we walked down the hill, and we went back on the bullet train to Tokyo. And I was chatting to the actress after. She said, he hasn't always been a Buddhist sensei, He was a professor of quantum physics at Harvard University for many years. He used to write books about all this, and went, you know what? Screw that, I'm going to go and live it. So he was living it right up there. Went back morning. Oh, ohayou gozaimasu, Kanemi-san. All right, okay. I said, can you all do this for me? Well, so all the actors, can you do it for me right now? So all the actors did this. I said, you know what? Can you understand this? That this is the Western perception of self. You know? And maybe some of you suffer from this as much as I do from time to time, I told them. And I said, you know, this is the illusion of ego. We can throw it away right now. And I said, where do you begin and I end? It's all about our interbeing. We're all connected, right? And even the plants and the bees and the spirits, it's all about one thing, the coming and going and living and dying of matter, of thought, of word, of deed. Some crying and some laughing and some actually recognizing themselves as being part of the whole thing. Forever and ever and ever and ever and ever and ever. Thank you so much, they said, for bringing your Western philosophy to our show. No, it's not me. I said, it's the guy in the red dress up on the mountaintop. So why I tell you this is because when we see theatre like you've seen theatre today, where there are two people here and they're committing to that connection, I recognize how interconnected they are. But as an audience, audio, as spectators, as people who can see this and feel this, we recognize we're part of that whole thing. And one of our jobs as actors and directors and theatre makers is to create conditions whereby people can feel real things and get in touch with reality. Which is not this isolated Western way. It is about this. Maybe it is all about that. But it's all about truth and connection. And if we can find, maybe not this, maybe some other thing, but the philosophical and psychological underpinning of your own work as individuals, then that whatever you do will be fueled by that.
So just put down the mask.
Put down the what, Ali?
Mask.
Put down the mask, yeah, but it's difficult to do. Because we might get hurt. But that, if we put down the mask, then of course we might also find love.
Yeah, but even if you are hurt, there is an experience behind it. If you learn to take the goodness and bad experience.
Sure. Which is why I say, sometimes we need to go out of our minds in order to come to our senses.